behind the album reveal, because I've read some reviews and some say it's a sad album, some say it's a happy album. How do you define it?
You know, I think as with so many of the combination of our music and Michael's lyrics, there's an element of melancholy, but usually by the end of the song there's some sort of very optimistic feeling by the end of it. Especially this record. I think this record on the whole is a very light record, and not a down record at all.
Very inspired people, so you never know when a song might come flying out of you. For Mike and Peter, it's more music. For myself, it's more words. I told the last guy I talked to, I'm not really a great lyricist, I'm a great editor. The words come flying out, and they're a mess. But I'm a pretty good editor, so I can take the best of them and put it together in some form that resembles a pop song. And that's kind of what we do. That's cinema, that's Hollywood. Come on, no one can see each
other. You know, when you write a song and when you make the arrangements of the song, do you imagine a situation? Because like in Imitation of Life, when I first listened to it, I thought of myself walking on the beach and something like that.
The thing to me about music as a medium, over movies or photography or painting or any other kind of creative medium that I can think of, is that when I hear great music, I get a picture. I get this whole landscape, and that kind of landscape is the thing that I think makes me music. A really phenomenal and powerful. I'm pushing an elephant up the stairs. I'm tossing up punchlines that were never there. Over my shoulder, a piano falls, crashing to the ground.
So why, when you first started, why did you decide to?
Well, because we love to play music, you know, we're music fans.
We had nothing else to do.
Well, I mean, it's like, what else were we good at? Nothing. I mean, well, Michael's good at things, but
not at 19.
I mean, really, we—that's
we
all we knew how
students.
To do. Yeah.
Can you go out on the streets walking like a regular person, or there's always somebody to you to ask for autographs and photos?
When I see somebody on the street that I recognize from TV or from a magazine, I want to run up and go like, hey, you're cool, you know, or hi, I know who you are, or even if you don't even know what they do. So it's a kind of a natural human thing, you know.
Yes, it is.
So when you went to Brazil, how did you like it?
We loved Brazil. We actually only got to see Rio, but that was plenty. We had a great time.
I was so happy in January to be in the sun that I threw my clothes off and went running through this. No, I didn't, but I wanted to.
So our show airs at night, and we always like to know what people like to do at night. What do you like to do?
If there's a good band playing, or you know, a band that I think might be interesting, I like to go out and see them. Go out for a nice dinner, meet Michael for a drink after dinner. Seems to happen.
It happens quite often.
Fairly often.
I like to go out and I like to be in a room with people. Just to watch and just to be in that kind of, I don't know, I like socializing in that way.
Why did you decide to be open about that question of your sexuality?
I need to set the record straight for all the Brazilians.
Uh-huh. Okay.
It's not really news in 2001 mm-hmm. That I'm queer. It's something that I announced about 7 or 8 years ago. I'm as puzzled as anyone as to why the British tabloid newspapers decided to put this as their headline, and then it went around the world. Mm-hmm. It's kind of old news.
Yeah, why do you think people have so much interest about private life and all these tabloids and
Oh, it's human. We're all nosy and we all love gossip and everybody wants to know everything. That's not a big deal. Frankly, I found it kind of funny. I mean, it was like, wow, that's really old news. But that's just human nature. People like to know that stuff. It's not a big deal.
Okay.
Yeah. Alguém chegou a ver o show deles? Não, ao vivo. Os três aqui. Gostou? Foi bom?